40 Days of Love, 40 Days of Love, 5.2 Shabbat. So let's talk about Shabbat. What is Shabbat? Shabbat is the time between Friday sundown and Saturday sundown where the Lord comes and you trust the Lord. You know, you do, some people do prayers, people celebrate in various different forms through various different religions. You know, Kabbalists and celebrated by, you know, studying the Zohar a little bit more, having the Torah out, doing songs, welcoming the energy of Shabbat on Friday night, downloading the energy of Shabbat on Saturday morning during the lecture and the scanning of the Torah and whatnot, and then asking, you know, closing out the night of Shabbat and the festivities and being like, hey, I did all this kind of different consciousness to the closing out of, there was a different consciousness to all of the segments. But some people are like, hey, you know, I did all this stuff. Can I get some stuff now? You know, some people ask for healing, protection, whatnot, pay me things for other people throughout the world. The best way to share is by asking for somebody else and letting go of what it is you want for yourself, because the Lord knows what you need. So once you let go, the more you let go, the more you receive. So Shabbat. Even now, I was thinking to myself, I wanted to make this video, and then I wanted to make that video, and then I was like, I kept blundering, and I thought to myself, who, what, and then Shabbat came forward and be like, I want to be heard, and I'm like, all right, that's cool. Let's talk about Shabbat. So what are the things that people do during Shabbat other than doing the services? Well, Shabbat has great, you're basically getting the energy for the rest of the week from the light of the Creator. So what I recommend is talk to somebody, a rabbi or whatnot, particularly the Kabbalah Center, and ask them, what's Shabbat? You know, and then can I go? And then they might go and be like, no, you're not ready. Or they might be like, come on down. You know, so it depends on your energy. It depends on where you are. You know, for some people, it can be really like, even for me, I think that there's times when I go and I can be very judgmental about what's going on. It's like, you got such a big religion, you know, and then all of a sudden, you know, celebrity sits right down next to me and we're like chatting up like two schoolgirls. And I'm having to think to myself, maybe I'll check on my little show, you know, during the Torah reading. So it's all, so it's this, it's just a lot of energy, a lot of energy. So some people just, their vessel, you know, may not be able, or, you know, some hiccups throughout the process. I don't know, but ultimately it's about arriving in love. And you can get past those hiccups because the soul is infinite. So that's what I believe. Is that true? Do you agree? Do you disagree? That's what they say. What are the things that you don't do during Shabbat? Well, people don't have sex during Shabbat. Yeah. Usually Friday in the morning, you know, but at night they're like, nope, no sexy nothings, nothing that has to do with the sexies, because the sexies are, as a law, is a very strong energy. It's like 1% of heaven, and when you're tapping into the energy, there's a drawback, and if you're not tapping into it properly, there's a bigger drawback. So especially when you're studying, you know, when you get higher up there, you know, the light kind of be like, hey, listen, you know, you need to, hey, you know what I mean, be a little bit more careful with that. So all that kind of stuff. No sexy stuff. So no sex during anything that involves the sexiness during Friday sundown to Saturday Sunday. No sexy stuff. And you know what I'm talking about. Not just, you know, other people with other people sexy stuff. It's you alone sexy stuff. You know what I'm talking about? So all that kind of thing. So you've got that element. And then also a lot of people restrict on, well, but you like sharing. Like, I didn't make any videos, if you noticed. And I didn't make any videos because I, you know, wanted to rest with the light of the Creator. So that's what I believed. So what do you think? Do you like Shabbat? Do you love Shabbat? Do you get excited about Shabbat? Now, I have not been going to Shabbat services because if you go back to my first video and if you subscribe to my channel, I don't feel safe at this moment in time within my community. So I'm seeking to address that safety that I personally am encountering, and not just for me, but for the rest of the world, because my intent, this is a red flag, not just for myself, but as a red flag to realize that I am within a community. And if it's gotten to the point where I feel all very safe with the light of the Creator, and if you, this, a whole book could be written about this whole situation, and but for the Lord to allow that to happen must be the Lord being like, hey, listen, you need to do something different because it's not just happening to you. It's happening to a bunch of people. And that's my thought about it. So that's why I decided to make the 40 Days of Love. What are your 40 Days of Love? I want to wish you all a wonderful, wonderful,